welcome back. Random TV Reviews, your girl Anel.
And your boy, Stanley.
All right, coming back with power real quick because we have to go to lunch with our niece at the last minute.
Yeah.
So anywho, got a few minutes to kick it with y'all. Y'all want to kick it?
Well, yeah, let's do it.
All right, let's go ahead and do the YouTube thing. Get it out the way. If you're not a subscriber or a family member, go ahead and hit that button. Go ahead and put the bell on because the bell lets you know when we drop another exclusive.
Yeah.
We're not ones that just come around and just drop. When we drop a video, we're dropping a video. So you'll get those alerts onto your mobile device. Go ahead and rate the video. Thumbs up, thumbs down. It really don't matter. You've already been counted.
Hey.
So, power, are we on the same team?
Are we on the same goddamn team?
At this point, I don't really care whose team anybody is on because it looks like everybody's losing.
Yeah.
No one has control over
nothing.
So I'm sitting here like, what am everybody, I watching?
Everybody is falling apart.
But I will say, last week, we were confused. The whole port thing was confusing. It still is confusing.
Yeah.
So I said, you know what? Let me go ahead and watch some of my fellow YouTubers that, you know, we enjoy their reviews just as much as, you know, they enjoy ours. And everybody was confused.
The same consensus came from everybody.
So I was like, okay, so it's just not us.
Yeah.
Mike B said he watched it twice. Yes. Oh, Mike B, y'all make sure y'all watch this because he does the best power reviews in my opinion. And he was like, I still don't know what the hell happened at the port.
Yeah.
Who called what?
Maybe we might find out down the line somewhere, but right now we don't know.
But the common consensus is every last one of these goddamn drug lords are crazy as hell.
Hell. Yep. All of them need help.
But y'all should have kept Lobos. If y'all want to go with the crazy theme, at least he was funny. And he wasn't creepy.
Yeah.
But anywho.
He kinda, well, he wasn't creepy. He was just weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is where I get off. You should have told me it was a party.
Ooh.
But anywho.
But anywho, so we're not going to go through every single detail scene. We're going to talk about the stuff that we feel like is relevant and give our thoughts on and move on and get out y'all way. So pretty much we picked back off kind of where we left at last episode. Ghost has killed the dude and he thinking that this was going to make things right, making things better for this family. But come to find out, it made it worse. So like we said last week, now they think the daddy was the one that killed the guy that killed his son, which makes sense because he's the one that was open about I think this guy should be dead. So Tasha brings that information back to Ghost because she went to the grieving group by herself this particular time and she heard them say that,
and she knew
and she
know her man.
Yeah. And she and they even look more hurt. And so like the mom was like, no matter how many dead bodies there are, it's not going to bring our son back, and which is true. So sometimes people do that, but you know, people grieve a little bit different. So
and Ghost kills.
Yeah. So Tasha goes back to Ghost and be like, the guy and the lady at the what you call the guy that killed their son, is he dead? You don't know anything about that, right? He said,
I don't know anything about it.
He said, please tell me you didn't kill him.
I didn't kill him.
And she saw that look in his eye. She was like, why did you do that? You made it worse for that family.
Yeah.
Why did you kill him? Just like every dead body we gonna have ain't gonna bring Raina back. So it's the same thing. You see Ghost wheels start to turn then like, yeah.
So now it's personal. Now you realize, okay, what I thought I was doing a solid for them and bringing some peace into their life since we don't have no peace right now.
Exactly.
It just made things worse for him, for them.
Yep.
So now I'm feeling it too.
Exactly. So now you look at now, he gonna have to hire a lawyer to prove that he didn't kill this guy on top of trying to deal with the loss of their son.
Let's just hope that old boy was at work or something like that where he clearly clocked in somewhere.
Yeah.
And he clearly was there.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, then you got old boy. I know in the other shows he played that he a lawyer.
Yeah.
So maybe he could self-represent himself.
So he definitely needs an alibi. Because if not, he may be going to jail. Especially if John Mockdom get on the case. Because he can spin a case and get you locked up.
Yeah, he can.
Yeah, so we hope. So, I mean, it made me think sometime in life you think you helping somebody. But you also making it worse for them.
Mm-hmm. Trying to take matters into your own hands.
Yeah. So, now we have Teresi is getting ready to get out of jail. And he tells Tommy. So at this point, Tommy is paranoid out his mind. You know, Tommy's already paranoid anyway.
Well, he should be, though.
Yeah. That this man had life. Now all of a sudden, some people pull some strings. I don't know the details. I'm too old to know about the details. But
play that real.
I'm getting out.
Ain't it funny how old people do that?
Yeah.
When they don't want to tell you nothing, you know, they too old for the details. They don't really remember. But let it be something on you.
Exactly. So that's why time of wheels is turning. So Tommy, we see Tommy go over to talk to Keisha, but I think his purpose was twofold. He wanted to get that off his chest, and he wanted to get some cooch. But Keisha was like, okay, sit down. What you want, Tommy? So he tells her exactly what happened, that my daddy is getting out, and I don't trust it.
Yeah, because it don't make no sense to me.
Yeah. So she was like, well, anybody that you can go and find out some references to find out who he really is and...
Find out, is this a legit release?
Yeah. He was like, yeah.
I said, leave Proctor alone.
He said, I know somebody. So he tried to lean on it and try to get something. Keisha was like, nope, not today. So Tommy, we seen Tommy go over and talk to Proctor. And Proctor's like, you know what? I ain't even supposed to be seen with you right now.
Can you do me a favor? Don't call me.
Don't call me no more. Don't text me. Nothing. Don't Facebook me, Instagram, or nothing. I ain't supposed to be around you, but it all checks out. It all looks legit.
Because they made it look legit.
They made it look legit. Because he was like, you know that little C form that I filled out? He was talking to when Teresa was talking to John Mockdown. That little C form, whatever it's called. So I'm trying to figure out, what's the connection here? It's like, why are they letting him out? Did he really snitch?
He had to.
Or if he did snitch, who did he snitch on?
He is snitching on Tommy and them. It has to be.
You think so?
It has to be.
And what threw us for a loop, he was saying to them that he's acting like he's Tommy's father. But I was like, wait. The mama even confirmed that Teresi was the daddy. So is he pulling John Moxton? Lady?
Yeah, I was confused about it all.
I really was confused. I'm like, is you the daddy or is you not the daddy?
But the part that tripped me out was John Mockingham came to Teresi acting as if their leads led them to come talk to him. And yeah. Teresi was like, y'all so stupid.
I got y'all to this point.
I got y'all to come here.
I pulled you in.
So that you all can get me what I want. And so that I can get out and spend the rest of my our days together, because you know his wife get ready to die.
Yeah.
So we could spend the rest of our days together. But no, you ain't got the upper hand in this. And Mark was looking at him like,
what?
Hold on.
Like, we thought we had you, but you got us.
And he even called Tommy on the phone in front of Mark and them, was like,
I'm getting out.
So I said, okay. And even when Tommy was talking to Kanan about it, and he was like, something don't sit well with me. You don't get out with a charge like this.
He said, I got out like that.
I said, well,
how did you really get out?
Because I don't remember now.
I don't remember how he got out.
I ain't going back to try to find out. I ain't even gonna lie. But I was like, I'm still trying to figure out what is Teresi's deal. Now, I never trusted him at all.
From day one, yeah.
But I knew that he had some connects that Tommy could benefit from.
Yeah.
But what is it?
And then he said the only reason why I'm in here is because I'm not a snitch. So now all of a sudden you became a snitch? Now I know his weakness is his wife. Kinda, because she about ready to die.
Yeah.
So, you know.
So is it the money grab? Because she... But they got... I don't know.
I don't know.
We're trying to figure it out just like y'all trying to figure it out. And if anybody has figured it out, leave it down below, because I would love to hear y'all's theory about what the heck is going on.
So now Ghost and the snake in the grass is trying to get Linda to be an investor.
You said it right first time.
Yes. Trying to get Linda to be an investor in their project. So they down there pitching the ideas, and retail came up in a conversation, and snake in the grass face was like,
Councilman T.
Mm-hmm. So Ghost were trying to sell it to her, like, we're gonna have retail, we're gonna have stuff for the kids, you know, it's gonna change the community, da 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 da. And she was like, well, this is not for me. Which I would have said the same thing, because Snake in the Grass wanted $12 million. Y'all want $12 million and y'all ain't deciding on what's gonna be in there, but you want my money. So she was like, no. So when he left, here goes Snake in the Grass talking about some, well, you need to let me take control of this.
And you need to take some time off.
Yeah, we never talked about retail. You need to take some time off. Ghost was like, don't forget that you pimped my daughter's funeral. You pimped me along the way on this whole thing because you knew I got the connections and I know how to make this thing happen. Because Snake in the Grass talking about you out of your league. But you brought him in to help you out.
Yeah.
Come on now.
So both of y'all got something to gain out of this. So don't act like you doing him a favor.
So Ghost said, you know what? I got this. So we see.
And we know what that means.
So we see him having dinner where I said, this is the ding-a-ling time to try to get this money back.
And like.
Well, not back. Get this money.
Like Nephew Thomas said, we about to see the feathers on Ghost back again. And we did that. That sex scene was so awkward.
Yeah.
It was very awkward.
So he go out to dinner. They talk. It was quick. She was like, bring the wine. So she was like, you know, what is this really for? He was like, to be honest, this is what it's really for. He said, I grew up in Queens. I know it's hard. So I wanted to, bring a better environment for the young people so they can have something to do. And I'm doing this for my daughter, Raina. Because I don't want nobody else's kids to end up or another family to end up where we are. So she said, grab the wine bottle. Let's go on back to the room. I said, we know what this is about.
Now, them details.
Yeah. And yeah, that scene was crazy.
That was awkward.
It was very awkward. But he bucked her and still didn't get the money.
That's it. So she basically.
She pimped him.
She pimped him out.
Pimped him out.
Rashad Tate was like, you did all of that.
And you still didn't get the money.
And we still don't have Linda's money.
Yeah.
And Ghost was like.
But I knew from the jump, I said, yeah, she is setting him up to get what she want, but she ain't gonna give him what he want.
And I was laughing the whole time. The whole time she was talking to him, she said, yeah.
And she took a wedding ring off.
And when she slid them jokers off, I said, ooh.
I said, yep.
I told Stella, I said, she one of them old rich, and husband probably got a little bit of change too. He probably over there doing the TI, doing whatever he want to do.
Yeah.
And giving you real good gifts on your birthday and whatnot. And,
yeah.
But he ain't really putting it down. So homegirl was like,
this is my opportunity.
You look like you can fit the bill. Let's
do it. So I ain't going to try to break down this whole thing with Dre and Crystal Ball and all them. But we just going to say this right here. Dre is having major problems.
He's way over his head.
Yeah, he having major problems. He got problems with Peanut because he took the gambling piece from Peanut. Now, Peanut is pissed off because you remember we saw in this episode, Kanan. Because they were trying to figure out how they can get Dre. He was like, Kanan was like, I know somebody I can go talk to that can probably get the job done for us, which was Peanut. So he met with Peanut. He saw Peanut. And within 30 seconds, he got Peanut to tell him that he lost the gambling spot. And Kanan was like, well, he treating you like your police. So you say you remember Brock. And Dre told Peanut that Brock had skipped town because he had a couple of bodies on his belt, so he needed to disappear.
Kanan
but that
said,
was a lie.
That's a lie.
He said that's a lie. He treated like the police. You remember he started running his mouth off at Tommy them. They cut his tongue off, and then Dre shot him in the head. So he lying to you. So that got Peanut wheels turning right there. So now we saw a scene where Crystal Ball was picking up the money. And Kanan robbed him. But what was weird was when Peanut screwed up, Peanut lost his spot. But we saw in the meeting when Dre was calling himself trying to wrangle everybody together, be like, this is how it's going to be. Crystal Ball is still number two, but he messed up that.
And he has the control while he tries to mess around and do the international stuff. So in actuality, Crystal Ball is actually number one.
So I don't know what the rest of the conversation that Kanan and Peanut had, but when Dre was asking, was everybody good?
Peanut
and the other dude was like, yeah, we good.
Skippy Scampy?
Whatever his name is. Glasses. So they was like, but they gave each other the eye like,
we ain't good.
Yeah, we ain't good and we got this. So I got a feeling that them two is going to get together and try to take out Dre.
But I think Crystal Ball's gonna take out Dre, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I really do at this point.
Yeah. So, just to come back to the scene where Crystal Ball had got robbed, he had got robbed because Kanan wanted to get in with Tommy in that distribution game.
But he ain't got no money.
So Tom was like, hey, I let you in, but you had to put up money just like everybody else. So, you know, of course, Kanan, he gonna steal the money. So, he got the money. But check this out. The money that he stole was the same money in the same bags that he stole from the truck.
So, he presented that to Tommy in the same bags of which
quarter of $1 million.
Mm-hmm. So I said, when they go to hand that bag over, they're going to trace this all the way back
to Tommy. So they're going to think Tommy was in the... they're going to think Tommy put the hit because he saw there was a black person behind that mask.
Yeah, because so they know it ain't Tommy.
Yeah, so he going to know, he going to think that Tommy put a hit out. So I don't know how Dre's going to fix all this. Dre is well over his head.
Dre need to smoke some weed and calm down and get some real clear thoughts.
Cause we seen in the meeting the Jimenez, what's his name, Diego. He was talking to one of the other Toros Locos because we saw that he giving credit for Peanut's kill to this other Toros Locos guy.
And too much.
Peanut mad because of that. It's like, I did that, but you giving credit to this dude. So it's just.
It's a lot.
It's a lot going on to try to break that down. But like we said.
Y'all watched it.
Yeah, y'all watched. So Dre is well over his head. And I think his mission gonna fail.
And Diego does not respect Dre at all.
He don't respect him at all. He wouldn't even let him speak. He said, why every time I ask a question, you gotta give the answer. I didn't ask you.
He's obnoxious. It's getting on my nerves.
He was like, how do you put up with this?
And then he continues to talk to Cristobal.
Yeah, talk to Cristobal.
And I was like, and Cristobal's just looking over there like, don't even worry about it. I got this. So Cristobal's going to take Dre out. I got to feel it.
Yeah, I got to feel either that or, of course, Kanan I'm trying to get him to. So one of them going to get him first. That's what I believe. But I don't know. Because we know Power can throw us a curveball. And we know Dre be on top. And everybody else did.
And he be in the opening credits and say, it's a big rich town.
Yeah.
And we see his goddaughter face walking down that.
Yep. So now we see that pretty much all this bullshit is leading back to Angela. Because your mama Angela went to the school to talk to Tariq about the killing. And so now Tamika done found out that she was there.
Not Tamika.
Gosh, what's her name? I keep on getting them.
I keep forgetting her name.
Yeah, whatever her name is.
The other
local police officer.
Yeah, from New York.
Yeah. So now she's going over still questioning Angela about why did you go to the school? And hey, Angela, I told you this is a private investigation.
Can't talk about.
I'm not at liberty to tell you what's going on. So right after that, we see the FBI going to her office and confiscating all of her files. And she was like, how can you do that? Do you have a warrant for this, or a subpoena, whatever, to give her the paper to show? And they took all her files and said, you no longer can mess with the Ray Ray Rainer's case. You're off of it.
And she looked on the paper and she said, Valdez.
And okay. She was like, you know she's covering her own AWS.
And Donovan was looking like, that I do know.
But do you have any proof?
She ain't got no proof.
Ain't got no proof.
So for some reason, I'm thinking that Donovan and this lady gonna end up working together some kind of way.
You think so?
Because Donovan is actually a good one.
Yeah, because last season they had him up in a bunch of skit. And he just went off in court. Just went off.
He said, hold on.
I've been doing this too long for y'all to bring me in this bullshit.
I'm a good brother.
Huh.
Trying to do right by the law.
So then we see Keisha and Tasha talking.
That was a real scene right there.
It was a real scene. And Tasha was like, I don't understand how Tariq ended up the way. Because, no, Keisha asked him how Tariq doing. She was like, I don't know how in the world Tariq ended up like this. Tasha was like, you know how you raise your hand in class? Ooh, 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 ooh. I know.
No, yeah.
I know
no,
how
Tasha.
You. I mean, Keisha.
Keisha.
Yeah. It's like, I know. Y'all made him that way. Y'all have lied to this boy since he's been on his ice. Y'all have lied to him. You turned him into a liar. And then when Keisha saw the look on Tasha's face, she was like, I'm sorry. I've abused you. I don't look like Kanye say, I'm sorry for talking to you so rough.
So have it back then.
What's your name again?
God bless you to you and your family.
And finally Tasha listened, was like, you know what? It's all
You're
good.
Right.
You're right. That is the truth. I have lied to him, and now he's lying. So we see Tariq and Tasha in the truck, and she proceeds to apologize to him and say, I'm so sorry.
And she told him the truth.
Me and your dad was raised in Queens in the projects. We had a hard life. We call ourselves trying to protect you. And we lied to you. And I am so sorry. But all we was doing was trying to protect you.
Mm-hmm. And she basically told him, said, you know, this is who we are.
Yeah.
Without telling you what it is that we really do.
Yeah.
She's like, running drugs won't gonna get you where we are.
Yeah.
So your dad was the business side of everything. So basically, we some summer bees in these streets. But that ain't the life I want for you.
Yeah, that ain't the life I want. I wanted to shield you and Raina from all this, but it didn't work.
It didn't work. So he confessed.
He confessed.
Finally.
He finally confessed, and he was like,
he saw it.
I saw it. He said, I froze. I didn't know what to do. I froze.
And he saw her die.
And he said, I miss her so much, and he broke.
So finally, that's how I feel sorry for Tariq.
I feel sorry
this episode.
Yeah. So I didn't think about that weight that he's still holding that weight of.
And guilt.
Yeah. Because
she came to protect him, really.
Yeah, she came to protect him. So she was like, leave my brother alone. She got shot. So I think that was a real powerful moment for all of us. Sometimes you have to be real with yourself and be like, I got to tell the truth to my kids, my mama, my aunt, to make things better. It's a whole lot of people out here still screwed up because somebody lied to them and won't tell them the truth.
That's the truth.
That is so true. So now you going through life, you all stressed out, depressed, going seeing psychiatrists and counselors and stuff, trying to get your life together because somebody else won't tell the truth.
That's it. And then the bad thing about it is how crazy that it'll morph into other things.
Yeah.
You'll look at your neighbor down the street and swear to God, they got it all together. Mm-hmm. And their life is so peachy. But get in a conversation on with them.
And you'll find out.
And you'll find out.
They got a bunch of bullshit going on too.
And matter of fact, they will take your problems.
Yeah.
In exchange for theirs.
Yeah.
So, yeah, don't ever idolize what somebody else has got.
Yeah.
And don't, because, like, some of y'all be talking about some of y'all goals. We got a good life. I ain't even going to lie. But it comes with a healthy price. You hear me?
A price that you pay and continue to pay to have it.
Hello.
Yeah. It never go on sale.
It don't, uh-uh.
And you can't put it on layaway.
We pay a premium price for the life that we have.
Yes.
And everybody can't do this.
And it
Because sometimes I don't know how we do it.
And it don't come in a generic brand either.
This name brand.
It's name brand.
Name brand.
Yeah.
It's some skit.
We throw that in there for free.
Uh-huh.
So we see Tommy going over to pick up Teresi. And he's like, what we gonna do? He said, first of all, I want to go get something to eat. Then I need to go see Connie. And then we're going to get into some trouble. Then the episode went on.
Mm-hmm. But are we still forgetting that Tommy has his tracker on his freaking car?
Yeah, I thought about that. Yes, because, yeah. So because we ain't never seen
it. I didn't
never
see anybody take it off.
I ain't never see nobody take it off.
Now, Power, y'all better not start writing like Empire and never putting stuff,
together.
Because we credit y'all for doing really good writing on this goddamn show.
Yeah, but other than that, this was a really, really, really good episode.
Oh, I got one more thing I want to say.
Because
somebody put it in our comments and it had me thinking a little bit. And then this episode right here kind of brought it to a head for me. Somebody said, wouldn't it be something if Kanan was actually the twins' father?
Ooh.
And that's how that's how Tariq got so hood. Before I was rudely interrupted. Is that a reason that Tariq is so hood? Because even Kanan said last episode, little nigga hard.
Yeah.
Way harder than you were back in your day.
Exactly.
And who did Ghost learn from?
Kanan.
So I'm sitting here like, y'all might be on to something. Because when Kanan came over there to talk to
Tasha.
To Tommy.
No, Tommy, yeah.
And Tasha was over there. You can tell there's some bad blood right there, for real. And he even grabbed her. He was like, I thought you liked to pull away. Like there's some history with them sexually.
And I know you like this. You like to fight.
Ooh. And she was like, you stay away from my family.
But you notice she paused for a second, too. And then she was like, you F with me again, I'll come after you myself.
I'll do the job myself.
Like.
And he was like, yeah.
Yeah.
And told Tommy, you don't mess with him. You were my family, not him. I said, hold on. Look, don't y'all be in the comments messing me up. Cause
that's something,
If it comes out later on that Kanan was them goddamn twins' dad.
Man.
And Ghost is only.
I got a feeling that's going to happen that way, too.
And Ghost is the daddy of the little girl that we never see.
Yeah.
Because of labor law.
Yep.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's some scary.
That would be big. That would be big.
Man. Oh, and Connie also told, not Connie. What's Tommy mama name?
Kate.
Kate told Tommy, said when your daddy get out, he wants something.
Yeah, because he the devil.
He is the devil.
And he gonna use you to get what he wants.
Don't get it twisted. He is coming for something.
Yeah.
Tommy know it. But hopefully Tommy is on his A game.
I think he on his A game because I think he gonna feel him out first. While he's out, gonna feel him out to see. And as he make requests, Tommy gonna start breaking all that stuff down.
Teresa looks like a corpse.
But it makes me wonder, if Tommy find out he is being set up, is he gonna kill his daddy? Or is that his daddy?
He almost killed his mama.
Yeah. So
he ain't gonna kill?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
He just
gonna... But he have a soft spot for Teresa though. He really do.
He does.
He has a soft spot.
Because he's broken.
That's a dad, yeah, that's a dad that wasn't in his life. And now this dad is coming back. That's every child's dream, that their dad will come back that's been absent. Yeah.
We got a lot to talk about in the comments, family. So
yeah.
We're going to go eat lunch with our niece. We late, straight from the VA.
The dirty, dirty South.
Two up, two down.
Holla.